So these 10 items sold for $716 profit. That's not revenue, that's money in my pocket. And now we're gonna go over each and every single one of them.
WBK Ultra.
What I wanna do now is just kind of explain what I'll be doing. We're gonna go over the screenshots of each sale. Now they occurred on three different platforms: Mercari, Amazon FBA, and Facebook Marketplace. So I'm gonna show you each of those. I'm looking at my phone right now, but my computer's right here, and I'll just screen capture it, and then you will see everything I see, with the exception of, you know, the person's address, because, well, because I can't just be putting people's addresses on the internet. The first sale would be Mortal Kombat, Deadly Alliance, and the PlayStation 2. I paid 25 cents for this game, nothing crazy, and I got $16.51. Now you might think, oh, on eBay you're going to be netting like $10, $11 profit, but it isn't really the same with Amazon FBA. They have an additional $1.80 video game charge. There's also that category fee for books as well. And so when it all broke down, out of the $16.51 and my buy cost of, you know, 0.25 cents, I made $9.56. Which, you know, you can take that two ways. Either, oh wow, that's a bunch of money for a PS2 game, or what are you doing? You're wasting your time. Why make 10 bucks on one sale? And the reason is because I didn't buy this game individually. I bought it in a lot of probably 25 PS2 games, and plus the PS2 itself, and I just piecemealed them out and sold them all together. Next item is going to be a Zenith XBV442 Progressive Scan DVD VCR combo. And I sold that for $118. I paid 10 bucks for it. 10 bucks is pretty standard for a DVD VCR combo in my area. If it's Sony, it might be at 20 bucks. But if you wait for the half off days, or if you just go to lesser known thrift stores like Goodwill, I don't even go there anymore for electronics. It's just so, the only thing Goodwills have in my area are vintage t-shirts and toys. Everything else is just, they pick it, which is fine, they're entitled to, but just so you know, don't waste too much time sourcing at Goodwills. If you have other chains, definitely go there. I bought this one, I think, at a Salvation Army based on the price, and out of the $118, what I got after the fees was $99.50. I paid $10, and so my profit is $89.50. And that includes, again, all the shipping, all that stuff that you're always talking about. It doesn't technically include inbound shipping, so take, let's see, a dollar off that. The next item is one you should always be looking out for. It is a camera, a Canon ZR-800. You may be gated on Amazon for this, but they're still selling for 70 or 80 bucks on eBay, and usually you can buy these for around 10 bucks. I paid 20 bucks for two of these cameras. I sold the first one a while ago. I say I would have bought these 2 months ago, maybe a month and a half ago. I didn't get them listed for a while. This camera was actually returned to me. They said it didn't work. I tested it out, it did work. I think they just didn't want to, you know, I think what they did is they used it and they rented it, basically. They used it for 2 weeks, filmed whatever they wanted to film, or watched, or transferred what they had to, and then sent it back to me. That kind of sucks because I paid, you know, the whatever fee on there. I'm not going to include that because, again, in my mind, returns are a different type of business expense. Like, when I look at my profit at the end of the month, I don't say, well, this item had this minus that return. I say, here was the revenue, here was the returns, here was the overhead business costs. That's how I look at it. So I'm not going to take into account the return, but just so you know, I think you end up paying shipping back to you. So it's like, actually, though, I take it all back. I disputed this with Amazon. The initial return fee and the removal fee would have been like 20 bucks, but I said, hey, this works fine. They didn't give me the right reason for why it was being returned, and they actually waived that fee. So I take it all back. This is why I say it's like a business expense, because if you can go through on one day of the week and go through all your returns and dispute them all with Amazon, Does it really make sense to take each return fee out of each item and then when I make these videos do it that way? No, it doesn't. What makes more sense is to make a video saying, here's how you dispute returns, and then when every dingus says, what about return fees, I just link to that. That's what I should do. If I was a more patient man, I would do that. Anyways, video cameras. Don't pay more than $10 for these. Don't buy them if they're the big, clunky, you know, on the shoulder ones. These take mini DV tapes. Generally, mini DV tapes is gonna be fine. If you're doing the VHS tapes or VHS-C tapes, it might take longer to sell. But as long as you're doing mini DV or just straight data, like, you know, 500 gigabyte memory camera, video camera, then you should be fine selling them, assuming they are brands. Like, if this was like some, you know, bullshit Chinese private label brand, which private label means like when I just go to China and order stuff, it could be like Blake's Cameras, you know, limited. Those aren't gonna sell, but Canon, Panasonic, Sony, all those name brands are always gonna hold value way, way, way better than just an off-the-street camera. Next one, another camera, Nikon Coolpix L340. I sold it for $118.97, and out of that $118.97, I got to keep, I got to keep $104.58. But I didn't buy this camera for cheap. I bought this camera on Mercari. I paid $40 for it. It was just a basic online arbitrage flip. The woman who sold it just said Nikon camera. She didn't have the actual model number on the listing. So I was able to buy it for $40 because no one else knew what the heck it was. Probably on Mercari, she could have sold it for $75. There's not a really good camera market on there. But on Amazon, it took about 2 months to sell. So I probably paid, you know, 40 cents storage fees. And even after my giant buy cost of $40, I still made $64.58. A textbook. Textbooks are great, even in the summer. I priced this one at, let's see, $42. I probably could have priced more, around $60, and sold it in the fall, but I didn't really want to. It was a high sales rank, relatively high sales rank for textbooks this time of year. So I said, you know what? Let's just get it out the door. Out of that $42, I only paid a dime for the book. I got it at a Salvation Army around here on their dime book day. It was a really good find. I'm getting $27.78. That might seem crazy because out of $42, you're paying like $15 in fees. And for someone who's not familiar with Amazon FBA, they might say, oh, why don't you just use eBay where your only fees are, you know, whatever it is, 10%, and then media mail. And the reason I don't do that is because I can guarantee you that this book would not sell for that price on eBay. And maybe, okay, I shouldn't say guarantee, but I can guarantee you that on average, textbooks sell for a hell of a lot more on Amazon. And so why do I care about the fees if my net profit is higher? If my net profit on eBay is $22 with $7 in fees, and my net profit on Amazon is $27 with $15 in fees, I would have to be a spiteful asshole to say, well, I don't want to pay more fees, I'll just take less money. I don't think you guys would do that, but in case we again get some dingus in the comments, that's why. Handheld games are a wonderful, profitable, fun market to sell. I bought this item, again on Mercari, for $4.75. It came in a 4-pack, there was 4 of them, Pocket Poker, Hearts, Hangman, and a different game. So I paid $22 for 4 of these. This is the last one to sell. It was the most expensive and the highest sales rank. The other ones sold for like $25 a piece. Anytime you can find these new in box handheld pocket games, always look them up. And I mean, if you can't look them up, I'd say $5 is a pretty safe price just to buy at. If you would say, hey, I've got, you know, 1,000 of these, I wouldn't buy 1,000 because that sounds like a scam. But if you're like, hey, I've got 10, $50 for 10, and they're all different, that seems like a no-brainer in my book. And the evidence for that is out of this $53.57, which is the sale price plus tax, so this guy had to pay tax, I was able to net $35.02. So that's $39.77 minus $4.75 is $35.02. On to Mercari. I love Mercari because it's a chronologically populating sales platform. That means if I list something, I don't have to worry about keywords or having a good rating like eBay. What I have to worry about is the price right and does it look cool? I shouldn't even say I buy these things though, because this sale was actually free. I made $27 off of these 2 free t-shirts that I got off of a church sale. They were outside in the box, it said free t-shirts, I said free, I'll take them all. I ended up donating half to Goodwill because they were worthless. The other half, I was able to sell like 8 or 9 of them. I only made like $40 off of this was not, like, in terms of hourly wage, not a good job, but in terms of ROI, like, if you're someone who has $0 and you want to make 40 bucks, yeah, you can sell free t-shirts. These two t-shirts specifically was one was an Einstein math t-shirt, and the other was a Elton John 1995 Made in England concert t-shirt that had kind of a beat up big chest graphic. Elton John has a movie coming out right now. There was no doubt in my mind that that's why it sold for 30 bucks, the two of them. The guy messaged me. I think he might be even a reseller. I don't know. I didn't really care. I said 30 bucks. Well, okay. After fees and everything, $23.75. Absolutely, I would want to do that. Now on to the Facebook Marketplace flips. These are great because there's no shipping fee. There's no commission you pay to Facebook for selling it. Everything you get after the cost of goods is just profit. The first one I sold is this vintage replogle 18-inch globe. It's actually a 14-inch or 12-inch circumference globe, but it's 18 inches tall, so that's what I said. From the 70s, and I can tell that by the countries they had on there. They didn't have certain countries that are now countries. There was a lot of Soviet bloc stuff going on and other things too that put it in the 70s. I sold this for $45. And I only paid $5 for it at a garage sale. It was part of a bulk deal. If you remember when I bought the Barry Sanders rookie card, which is right here, actually, still have it by my desk, and the Winchester dartboard, and the tapes that I showed you in a video two or three ago, this came with it. I got $5 for it. I got $40, and considering I only paid $20 for the whole lot, that makes that garage sale trip already profitable. Yeah, $40, some guy came by, picked it up. It was a 10-second transaction, which I love. Kind of an exciting item that I've been talking about for a month. I think it actually took a month exactly to sell. Was this lot of 67 vintage underground comics from the 60s and 70s. The two main publishing houses, it was Last Grasp and Ripoff Press. Those were two big publishing houses for underground comics in the 70s and 60s. If you don't know what underground comics are, they are science fiction or horror or gore or kind of like sexually oriented. When you look back at like what Disney was doing in the 50s and 60s and how family friendly it was and how fake it seemed to so many people, what they wanted to do was take this turn towards ultra realism, grittiness, and then even further, they wanted to get a reaction out of people by saying, okay, you're so used to this sort of friendly, stuffed animal, fluffy comic book. What do you do when you see skull or when you see, you know, something with murder or sex all over it? They are getting more and more collectible every year. So when we actually take into account the cost of insurance to mail it, you know, postage, I used FedEx for it because I want to make sure everything is fine on this delivery. I ended up making $375 before the cost of goods, and after the cost of goods, $305. So that's $375 minus $69 puts me at $306. Did I say $305? Well, whatever I said, it's $306. That's such a great flip. I had them just behind me for a month. I got to look at them all, read them all, and then sell them to a guy who actually cares a lot about these things. If he would have bought them all individually, it would have cost probably around $800. And so he got a good deal. I got a good deal. This is why I love reselling. The final item is another fun one too. It's a lot of records. There was about 60 records in here. I didn't name how many there were in the listing. That might have been my fault. I just took a picture of them all. A lot of them are promos. But there's also some really cool Def Jam records in there too. These sat on Facebook Marketplace for a year. A year! I had to keep lowering the price and relisting them, and I didn't promote them, but I would renew the listing. And then about a week ago, a guy said, "Do you still have them? I know it's been a while, do you still have them?" I said, "Yes." He said, "I can come there today." He drove by, picked him up, we talked about, you know, 80s, 90s rap for 2 or 3 minutes, which is the ideal engagement with a customer. 2 or 3 minutes of small talk about a niche topic. You pay me, you be on your way, we both live better lives. for these records, there was 60 here. I paid a quarter a record. That's $15. 15 minus 100 because their pickup and no shipping and no fees is $85. So when it's all said and done and you add these up, the Mortal Kombat video game, the DVD VCR combo, the camcorder, the camera, the textbook, the pocket game, the t-shirt bundle, the vintage globe, the comic books you just saw, and now this vintage vinyl lot, that's $716. I don't know what the revenue is. I didn't do that math. Over $1,000 maybe. But what we care about, again, is profit. P-R-O-F-I-T 716. Not a phone number, just a great alphanumeric sequence. If you like this video, if you like seeing how much things sell for so you can buy them yourself and make more money, give the video a thumbs up, comment below with your best flip, subscribe, and I'll see you later. And if you're really cool, there's a bell notification on that side or maybe that side, I don't know. Click that and you will be the first to see these great buys. Bye!